Welcome to the BioBalance Healthcast, episode 537, The Death of Title IX, and the End of Women's Equality.
BioBalance Health features conversations about anti-aging medicine. Your host is Dr. Kathy Maupin, Medical Director of BioBalance Health, and a leading expert in treating the symptoms of aging. Dr. Maupin and Brett Newcomb are the authors of The Secret Female Hormone, the seminal work about testosterone replacement therapy for women, and Got Testosterone, a book that helps men choose the most effective and safe form of testosterone replacement. These books are available on Amazon or from Dr. Maupin's office at BioBalance Health in St. Louis and in Kansas City. Dr. Maupin's office is currently accepting new patients.
Welcome to the BioBalance Healthcast. Today I'd like to talk about a very serious problem that has come up since the inauguration of our new president. I want to make clear that I am neither a Democrat or a Republican. I vote really for people who will keep America free, who will allow Americans to make their own choices and be responsible human beings. And also, I'm very partial to women in politics who can represent women and defending women's rights in the political scene, because if we don't have our rights, we can't be free. I was very disappointed and shocked at a presidential order, there were many of them, but a presidential order this January that was signed without discussion, without allowing the legislature or the House of Representatives or senators to weigh in on this decision. And it's huge. It's a decision that actually is going to change one of our amendments to the Constitution, and that's Title IX. Title IX is an amendment to the Federal Civil Rights Act, and it occurred in 1972. It was the right of women to participate in sports with equal funding with men. In other words, women could have money from colleges, high schools, from the federal government to actually support them as athletes. And before 1972, we didn't have funding, and we did not have many women athletes unless they were wealthy and they could be coached privately. It was not an era of women's sports like it is now. Title IX made all the difference, and it was the first step in women's rights that began in the 70s. I lived then. I went to high school. I was a junior in high school when Title IX actually was passed. It took years for it to actually become practical law in education. But when I was in high school, there were only two sports that women could participate in, and they were not funded. One was tennis, that we had to get ourselves to and from and was off-site because it was in a public park, whereas the men could practice on our high school grounds. And it was track, where we shared a coach with the men, and basically we were just kind of like, we were just decoration. It was not really coaching. It was just basically making sure we didn't hurt ourselves. So, and we really didn't have locker rooms where you could have a team changing at one time. That was really an impairment of our ability to be athletes, to become athletes throughout our lifetime, and to compete in the Olympics, to compete at higher levels. We were stopped in junior high and high school with no sports that was supported by the tax dollar. Title IX changed all that, and it was the first step in making work and professional schools actually look at women as equals. It was sports first, and then it was work, and then it was professional schools. Before that, we were looked at as second-class citizens. It was the biggest leap for women that occurred since the right to vote, which was in the 1900s. So, as a doctor, I think on this problem of allowing biologic males who have become transgender to compete against women, I have a unique viewpoint. I'm a gynecologist. I actually understand the difference in hormones and difference in physical stamina and strength between men and women. I also understand understand the difference in men and women's testosterone levels, which does make all the difference in their ability to play sports. The reason we divide men and women in sports is because women are not physically as strong or as big or as, they don't have the stamina that men do in terms of participating and competing against men. Basically, women have 1/10 the testosterone of men. And testosterone's a big deal in sports. Men and women are tested for testosterone levels to see if they are cheating. I view allowing men who identify as being a female in sports as cheating. They have 10 times as much testosterone. Is the next step that we allow people to have injections of testosterone who are not transgender so that they can compete against men? That would not be men acting as women, I'm sorry. That would not be healthy on any level, and it is not the right way to go. I believe that by violating women's rights, which is 50% of the population, we are giving rights to less than 0.2% of the population to actually cheat at sports. And it's not that true transgenders would do it knowingly to cheat at sports. However, there are many opportunistic people, and if they have a way to get a scholarship or actually, I mean, scholarship is money. It's a key to college education. So, or they get the ability to make their team win or be a star by changing genders, then I believe that is not a democratic change. Democracy means the best for the most people, and that is not the best for the most people. We take care of the small percentage of people who are transgender. We should be taking care of them by requiring insurance companies to pay for their transformation and to help them get through this because it's a very expensive process. However, I believe that transgenders patients who are biologic males becoming females so that they can participate in sports should have certain qualifications. If they're not going to rescind this executive order, which was made by a very old man who lived during the time before Title IX and really has not been touched by that, then if we can't rescind it, if we can't stop it, then the only way is to modify it. And in my letter to my representative in the House of Representatives, Ann Wagner, lists three things that could be done if we can't reverse this executive order. One is, biologic males must have a total testosterone of a female less than 40 nanograms per deciliter, which is the normal total testosterone of females. Men's normal healthy testosterone ranges 400 to 1500 nanograms per deciliter. If a man's going to compete with women, then as a biologic female, then he has to have his testosterone shut down. One of the ways to do that, there are some medical ways, but one of the ways to do that is to remove the testicles, which is part of the transformation from a male into a female. I think that biologic males who want to compete against women in sports should be completely through their transformation. That means that their genitals are removed, that they become physically like a female, that they are on estrogen, and this is what a transformation from a male to a female requires. It can't be just somebody who says, oh, I'm female, or identifies with it so that they can get a scholarship or they can compete in sports. against women and win, it has to be that they are dedicated. This is real. This is not just a fad or something that is, they just want to say this to rebel against their parents. This is something that has to be real, that has to be, these patients have gone through a lot of counseling with a psychiatrist and a psychologist to actually make this decision, but they have to make the last step so that they become as physically like a female as they can. These three things will have to occur for it even to be possible for biologic males to compete in sports against females. But we have another problem. Biologic males have been under the influence of testosterone ever since they were small, before they've made this decision. They're taller, they're heavier, they're bigger, they're stronger. Even without testosterone, they are going to be stronger than a person on the other team who is a genetic female. That is yet another problem you can't fix by surgery or by hormones. And that also is enough to unlevel the playing field. There's still another problem with men, male gender, who are transgender into females. They're going to be in the same locker room as your daughter. They may not have the same equipment as your daughter yet if they are not being required to be through their transformation. So they may look fully like a male. They are going to be showering with your daughter. And my daughter, I wouldn't let her compete in sports. That's another reason that you can't have transgender males into females become part of the team and be in the same locker room as actual gender and physical females, unless they're through the whole process. It's dangerous, and people who men who want to compete and work on a team with women are going to be a danger to them in the locker room, especially young men. So this is not something high school sports or college sports want to take on. The liability is huge. And I can't imagine that this is something that anyone in the government even thought about. I think it is limiting our freedom to participate in sports, our daughter's freedom to participate in sports. We are being, our whole view of ourselves and our sexual orientation is being pulled out from under us with one sweep of a pen. I can't tell you how important this is. It just seems, if you don't care about sports and women's sports, fine. But if you do care about your daughters or your wife getting a job that is equivalent to a male and paid at the same rate as a male, we still have problems with that. Do you want to turn it backwards? I mean, half our population should be standing up and screaming. But we don't, because we don't want to turn the apple cart over. We don't want to cause a fuss. We don't want to make a change. But it is women who did that, made a fuss, wrote letters to their senators and to their representatives and told them, and it has to be the federal level, not the state level, because that's, this whole law is in the hands of the federal legislators. So you have to get a hold of them. You can go on the internet, find their names and their addresses, send them emails. This is not something that can just be ignored. This is something that's going to happen, and it is going to change everything. Can you imagine a world where women can't go to the Olympics from America because they have a small number of gender or biologic males who we've allowed to win and get awards and compete against men? I can't imagine that world. And we've had our... In the last year, we have had our freedom cut by so many things that don't make any sense. This is another nonsensical law, and it doesn't make sense, and you should not accept it, and you should not vote for the people who are making this happen. This is not something, this is not a discrimination. This is this is making a law that actually allows the majority of the women in the country to compete on an equal basis in every area of our lives. Please don't let this just go by and accept it. You have to stand up and fight this. Thank you.
Email your questions or comments to podcast@biobalancehealth.com. You can find the BioBalance HealthCast on iTunes and on YouTube. For more information about bioidentical hormone pellet therapy and other reverse aging solutions, visit biobalancehealth.com or call 314-993-0963. You can find Dr. Maupin on Twitter at Dr. Kathy Maupin and on Facebook at facebook.com/biobalancehealth.